Hi there, I'm Michael McMurtry, and welcome to the Ingles Table. Today I'm going to show you how to make my African peanut stew. This stew is truly delicious and a unique combination of flavors that I'm excited to share with you. I got all the ingredients that I need right here, got it from my local Ingles, so let's get started. I already started by putting some olive oil and red onion and cumin and garlic into a pan, and I'm sort of sauteing that until it gets a little translucent. So that's going here, and now that I've got it translucent, I'm gonna add some ginger. And the way I like to put ginger in is with a rasp or microplane. So I just go like this. I like a lot of ginger, so we're gonna just stir that around, and then we're gonna add some sweet potato. And I've got a couple sweet potatoes here that I've cubed up. Put that in. This is a super easy recipe. It's very spicy. If you like spice, you can adjust it, of course. All right, stir that around, get all the sweet potatoes coated. We're gonna let that cook for just a minute, and then we're gonna add some vegetable stock. Of course, you can use chicken stock if you like. I like to keep this vegetarian. We've got some great Harvest Farms vegetable stock. This is one of my favorites. So we're gonna put like 1.5 boxes of this in, and we're gonna let this come to a boil. So just put a lid on it and let it come to a boil. And while that's coming to a boil, we're gonna make this other mixture. And this other mixture is a combination of peanut butter. And I got this peanut butter at Ingles. They've got these great machines that will grind fresh peanut butter. This is just 100% peanuts that have been ground up. So you add the peanuts in there, and then I add 6 ounces of tomato paste. So that's about half of this can. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna mix this together. It's really all thick and gloppy. So the best thing to do is once you get some temperature on this liquid here, just go in and take some of the liquid, like 1 or 2 ladles full, add it to this. It'll make it a lot easier to mix this up and then incorporate it back into the soup. So it's using a whisk, just mash this up, get it to a nice smooth consistency, and then we're gonna add it back into the soup. Feel free to make it your own by adding as many spices or vegetables as you like. So we're gonna add this in now to our boiling liquid, the peanut butter and tomato paste mixture. And once this comes to a boil, there's a couple of things you wanna do. You wanna adjust your salt and pepper seasoning, so add as much salt and pepper as you like. And then we're gonna add this great sauce that you can get at Ingles in the international aisle. It's called peri peri sauce, and it's a great spicy, kind of like hot sauce, but it's got tons of citrus in it too. So it's really bright and fresh. And you take and you add as much of that as you like, add some salt and pepper. And then the final step for this is we're gonna add some greens. So you can add any kind of greens you want. You can add kale, you can add collard greens, you can add spinach, but you wanna get some kind of a greenery in there, okay? So I've got some kale over here. I kinda like the larger pieces when I'm eating soup, so I just sort of rip it, okay? So I just add the kale in here. And then a great way to serve this is right over just some rice. You can use brown rice, you can use white rice. We're just gonna bring this up to temperature a little bit. We're back now. We've got this up to a boil. Our kale has wilted. You can also, once the sweet potatoes get soft, you can sort of mash some of them and it thickens up the soup a little bit. That's another option. But here we go. We're gonna serve this over the rice. I'm telling you, this smells so good. For a finishing touch, I like to take a lime, squeeze a little bit of juice over it, put a little fresh parsley on, and then a handful of dry roasted peanuts that I got at the Ingles Produce Department. I wanna thank you for joining me here at the Ingles Table. Be sure and check out the website for more tips, tricks, and recipes. I'll see you next time.